Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler. I want to take a couple minutes to show you a brand new 2019 Cougar travel trailer. This is a Keystone product. This is a Western Edition model, so it's made here in the Northwest. They build these in Pendleton. So they're made for the Northwest, have good size holding tanks, insulated really well, and matter of fact, they're 0 degree tested. So they consider the fact that, you know, we're going to be in a little more rugged climate here, probably in the Northwest. People get off the beaten path a little bit more, so really a great quality trailer. This is not entry level quality. Once we go through the coach, you'll be able to get a good idea of just how nice this trailer is. This is the 26RB is the model, so it's kind of in that middle size range as far as trailers go. Not too small, but not too big, if that's kind of your target range. This could be a good floor plan. Notice the front cap is, this is a hard, solid, molded cap, no seams in it. It has lighting up front here. The advantage with not having seams, obviously, the less seams you have in a motorhome or a trailer, the less chance you'd have of anything leaking, so you don't have to worry about keeping the seals good, because there are no seals, it's just one piece. Has a one-piece fiberglass, or not fiberglass, but a one-piece vinyl roof, so it's easy to keep maintained as well. You just have to maybe do a little maintenance periodically to make sure that the caulking around all your vents and air conditioning, that type of thing, is fresh and not all cracked and drying on you. That's where you tend to get a little bit of problem with leakage, but shouldn't have a problem with that. Front tongue jack is nice on this particular one, so it's easier to load and unload. Just push the button. It's going to go up and down. We're going to make sure you have two batteries up front, two propane tanks, 7 gallons, so you got two bigger propane tanks. So we swing around the other side here for just a second. This one has a electronic leveling system. This is an auto level. I'm not sure why it's not plugged in, but anyway, the idea being that this is something that once you get to where you're camped, you can just hit the auto level. Once you get your spot, disconnect from your rig, hit auto level, it's going to level itself out. Has a battery disconnect right here also. Got my hookups right here for fresh water too, so I can, my gravity feed right here if I just want to fill my water tank up. And this is if I've got pressured water, maybe you're at a park where you got water and power, you can just hook up your hose right to that. Nice good size slide out over on this side. Let's go back around the other side here. This is set up, it's already pre-wired for solar, for a portable solar panel. So I can plug in a portable solar panel right there. Again, if you're a dry camper, you like to get off the beaten path, you're not going to be plugged in somewhere. That'll help keep your batteries charged up. Good size storage compartment down here. This in-command system here, we'll talk about a little bit more once we go inside. But this is a panel that you can access, so you can manually adjust some things on your coach if you need to. Notice the aluminum framing, so it's got welded aluminum framing on the construction, so your flooring, your sidewalls are all welded aluminum, which makes it nice. It's really a good quality construction. You can kind of see if you look at all the corners, all the welds are all consistent, they're all full welds, it's not spot welded. So as I mentioned earlier, it's not entry-level quality, it's really put together nice. I like this little magnet too, so I can just flip that up and don't have to worry about it. Those slam latches are better than the little twist ones. Notice the size of the awning. This has a huge patio awning. LED light strip underneath there too, so I can turn on a light there. If I'm out here at night, I can have a nice soft light sitting underneath the awning, or even if the awning's not out, you can have the light on. Outside speakers, outside shower here, hot and cold water. You do have two doors on this model. Two ways to get in. This is the bedroom area here. Plug-ins for 110. Cable hookup right there. This one even has an outside cook center. I guess consider an outside kitchen. It's got a little grill, propane grill, that I can plug in. There's a, should be a quick connect right down under here somewhere that we can plug in, so I don't have to find a separate source for propane. And then you do have a looks like it's got all, this one's all taped up, but you do have, oh, let's see here, we can get in, let's see, it's got a little refrigerator that you can use out here as well. Maybe put some drinks or maybe some of your condiments, whatever you want to use out there. You know, generally this is the side of the trailer that you're going to be hanging out on, so it's kind of nice to have things like this. Just makes it more fun. Nice, good suspension on these. They've got a nice leaf spring underneath there to give you a good ride. Two axles on this particular unit. Notice some nice alloy wheels also. So, and this is all part of your leveling system too. You have two jacks up front, two in the back, that again are automatic. The other door to get into the back, 6 gallon hot water heater that's a fast recovery hot water heater. That one's going to heat up to 16 gallons an hour, so it heats really fast. It's got a ladder to get up on top in case you need to get up there and do a little maintenance. It is already set up for a backup monitor. Doesn't have it with it, but it's got a spot where you can put one on if you decide you want to do that. And then again, we kind of looked at this side. This is where your hookups are going to be. Here's your power cord in here. Pulls out, black tank flush right there. I can hook up a water hose to that with pressured water, keep the black tank cleaned out. And there's where your sewer dump's going to be right there. This is kind of the work side of your trailer. The other side's the fun side. This is where you hang out. This is where you hook stuff up. Definitely more funner over here. So 26RB is the model. WE means it's a Western edition. This has a climate guard. So basically you've got completely enclosed underbelly. Your tanks have heating pads underneath there also. So if you get out in some cold weather, you know, you're gonna be protected from things freezing up underneath there. Then command system, we'll take a look at that. I want to show you how this little new step works. This is really pretty slick. So this just slides up in here. It's got a little hook right there. It'll snaps into place, holds it in place, and then once I want it down, just bring it down like that. It just fits in with the door, closes. It's got the little lend-a-hand also too that swings around, makes it easier to get in and out. The nice thing about these steps though is they're really sturdy. People tend to really like these. So come on inside, let's take a look. Again, you might have questions, give me a call, 541-510-1017. Take a look up in here. And I don't have power to the coach right now, so I can't turn this on. But basically, once this is on, I can scroll through here and check. I can operate my slide out from here. I can kick my awning out. I can do lighting. Much of the things on the coach I can control from right here. Also has an app that you can download to your phone. If you have a smartphone, you can get that app on your phone. You can use your phone to do this same thing this one will do for you. And as I mentioned, when we looked underneath out there, it's got that panel there, so if you needed to override and want to do it manually, you can do it through that system. Here's your holding tank heating system that we talked about. Fresh gray, black, all of them have heated tanks. Nice stand-up shower in the bathroom. Got your sink and toilet. Use a porcelain toilet. The bowl is porcelain. Really nice quality. Look at the nice flooring in this. It's a nice vinyl floor. It looks like wood, but it's actually vinyl, so real easy to keep clean. This is another nice feature of this particular floor plan. It's got a nice deep cabinet back here for hanging clothes or whatever the case may be. Then you have a couple of big drawers also. So you get good amount of storage. Plus, it's got a pantry right here also, so you've got some storage here, here with more drawers. These drawers are full extension, so they pull all the way out, and they do have metal glides too, so they're nice and sturdy. Take a look at the big flat screen TV, 4K actual, Ultra HD, so they put a nice TV in here, and it's already set up for your DVDs, so if I want to watch a movie, I can just slide a DVD in there. It's already ready to go. If I want to listen to music, I can do CD. Even has a little USB port, so if you want to stream your own, you can. I think they're even, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, it has Bluetooth on it also, so. 8 cubic foot refrigerator, separate freezer from the refrigerator. Gas electric, so you can run it off either or. Does come with the microwave oven. 3 burner stovetop with a nice sink or a cover over the stove. So it's a little nicer unit that they've used in the past. So this one's got a little nicer oven also. But this is a gas oven here, so this runs off your propane. So you have propane oven, microwave. If you like to cook in your trailer, this would be a nice little setup. It's got quite a bit of storage underneath there. Great place for put a good size garbage can down there. Look at all the storage there. It goes back in there quite a ways. Lots of lighting in here too. So you got LED lights. Got quite a few plug-ins. There's 2 110 outlets right there. Residential style sinks. 2 stainless steel sinks, pretty deep. And then you got a sprayer. Even has a little spot here where you can put some, I guess that'd be for maybe some of your spices and that type of thing. A lot of windows in this unit too. That's one of the things that they've changed over the last couple years. They put bigger windows in. Notice how big the windows are on the side of the slide outs too. A lot of units that you might look at are going to have windows on the side. And some do and some don't, but these not only have windows, but they're big and they also open up. So you might find some that have windows, but they're one piece windows and you don't have the ability to get fresh air. You can open up both sides of these of the slide out and get a nice airflow through here, and almost all of these windows in here will open up too. Dinette makes into another sleeper. You got storage underneath here, and look at those drawers. They come out like a country mile. This will pull out too. It's got pedestals there. We can pull those out, drop it down and make into another bed. Just put these cushions in there. And then this is actually a sleeper sofa also. This one, what they call a trifold sleeper, so this is going to pull out and make into a bed also. So you'd have 2 beds out here if you need them, plus your main bedroom area has a king size bed, what they call an RV king. It's the regular width, 72 inches wide. It's just not the full 80 inches deep, so it's probably about 75 inches deep. Gives you the width, but not quite as long as a regular mattress. So it's typical in RVs. That's why they call them RV queens or RV kings. They're quite a little bit shorter. Storage on both sides of the bed and above. So you got a good amount of storage back here, plus a nice little shelf back there behind the head of the bed with a USB port. So you've got power you can plug in back there too. I think that you have 110 outlets on both sides of the bed, so if you need to maybe use a CPAP machine at night, you can put that, plug it in there. You got 110, a little shelf to put it on. Storage underneath the bed too. This all lifts up, so I've got a good amount of storage underneath there. On the other side of that is that pass-through area that we looked at from the outside. So set up, you can put another TV in here if you want. It's already got the power to it. Having a second door is kind of nice too, so you got 2 ways to get in and out of the motorhome. Pocket door here, or a sliding door I should say. So you have You can get some privacy back here. Really nice, nice floor plan. Keystone's a great product line. Most of our towable inventory is all Keystone. We like their quality. They're really a good value too. That's all they do is towables. They don't do any motorized. So, and the fact that they're built here in Oregon is a big plus for us too. They don't have to pull them halfway across the country to get them to our lot. So, real happy with the company. I think you'd be happy with the trailer. Again, maybe you've got something now that not quite as nice as what you'd like to have. This could be a good upgrade, or you know, certainly a good first unit too, where you could get something a little nicer than just the basic trailer. So give me a call. I'll be glad to help. It's 541-510-1017. Just ask for Jim.